my name is Eileen. I am a fifth year biomedical engineering student here at the University of Michigan Ann Arbor. Very happy to be here today to start my first vlog video. And a big shout out to the creative team at School of Information for giving us a great platform for us to voice our opinion from a diverse background. So let's get started. First of all, I am originally from Beijing, China. After I turned 18, I moved to the US for a college degree at Washington University in St. Louis for a biomedical engineering major. And after that, I decided to further my education and pursue a PhD degree also in biomedical engineering. So today we're going to talk about how to get a Michigan graduate school. And for this, I'm wearing my Michigan shirt today. So for myself, I entered the graduate degree program as a master's student in 2015. And after that, I immediately applied to be in the PhD program. So I do have experience of both. So today we're going to focus on the application process for both master's and PhD program. So speaking of GPA, here is one example from myself. So like I said before, I did my undergrad at Washington University in St. Louis. And here is what I used when I applied to be a PhD student here. And you can see that zooming in, I got a GPA of 3.65 when I applied. And breaking it down, you can see there are some A's and some B's. And there's even one withdrawal from a theater class that I could no longer fit into my schedule. So here I want to say that having a withdrawal is totally fine if the class is not related to your major, so that's easily justified. So for international students, I want to talk a little bit about writing. So you can see that here, when I first started, I took a fundamentals of academic writing when I was a freshman and got a C+. So this definitely does not make me look great on transcript. But what I did was I kept taking writing intensive classes and I kept improving. So by the summer of my junior year, I took a technical writing class and I got an A+. So this definitely demonstrates my progress and my effort in improving my communication skill as an international student. And I really can't emphasize this enough, and that is showcasing your communication skills in writing, in expressing yourself through conversations or presentations is so important, especially if your native language is not English. So for people who have GPA of below 3.5, you still have a very good chance. And this is the case where you really need to build your other aspects of your portfolio by providing a very strong publication record, a strong network with the professors at University of Michigan so that they can vouch for you. And finally, I have seen people get into Michigan PhD program with a GPA below 3.0. So if they can do it, you can also do it. So statement of purpose is a roughly 1,000 word essay describing your previous research experience leading up to where you are today and your overarching goal of pursuing a graduate degree here at the University of Michigan. So in this essay, there are actually a lot of things you can talk about, and there are no set of rules saying that you have to structure your essay in a very specific way. So you can talk about your previous relevant research experience. You can also talk about class projects that spark your interest in a specific discipline. And you can also talk about or start with a personal story that inspired you to pursue a certain degree. So there are many ways of writing it. And the bottom line is that the entire essay needs to be coherent and the connection between paragraphs need to make sense. Don't be scared to cut out experience that's not relevant to your story. So for international students, please make sure there's no grammar mistakes because that reflects the lack of attention to detail. So make sure that you put it through a grammar checker or have an English speaker actually looking at the essay for you a couple of times so that you don't come off as a sloppy person. And finally, make it school specific, and that is to spend a couple sentences talking about why you're interested in this school specifically. And this is so important because this tells the admission officer that you actually did your research. So personal statement is a Michigan specific essay that gives you an opportunity to tell the admission committee your unique background that leads you to Michigan. You can write anything you want that's relevant, but I recommend not overlapping with statement of purpose because this is a great opportunity to showcase a different color and different dimension of yours, so don't waste it. If you want to talk about a personal story, I recommend using a chronological order. And a lot of people would say that I don't really have an interesting and unique background. I just like science. I just like engineering. And that is a perfect reason. Talk about it. Talk about why you think it's an interesting topic, why you are naturally drawn to it, and talk about the experience that made you like it more. I'm sure everyone has a very interesting backstory, and sometimes it's just that you haven't found it in your memory yet. So go talk to a friend, go talk to a family member. And for international students, this is a great opportunity for you to showcase the environment that you grow up and show the level of diversity you can bring to the campus culture. Talking about cultural diversity, I recommend not talking about big ideas because this is very likely to overlap with other people. So talk about small examples, growing up, a childhood memory, a childhood experience. A small tip on writing. So when I'm stressed about writing and just desperately want to get it done, I usually think about how I can write a piece so that the reader can actually enjoy it and have a good time when they read it. So this way, I shift my focus from my own suffering to the enjoyment of another person. And this is how I overcome my writer's block. So for PhD applicants, networking is probably the single most important factor that is so underrated in the whole application process. And this should be done as early as possible. So if you want to apply later this year, now would be a really good time to get it started if you haven't done so. And you can start by going to the professor's lab webpage to go through their publication briefly and see if you're interested in their research and want to inquire about a potential research position as a grad student. Cold emails are generally appropriate, but make sure they are short, concise, and cut to the point. In my experience, a long, convoluted email is more likely to be archived or ignored compared to a short, concise email. But by short, I still mean 2 to 3 paragraphs, introducing yourself, express your interest in their research, and end with an inquiry for a phone call or a video chat. Finally, be a responsible person and do not mass send these emails. In each of these emails, be specific and be genuine and show your respect. So for recommendation letters, I have 3 advice. First, always ask one more person than what's required because emergency can happen. And I have seen people who went through a very stressful time because one of the recommenders couldn't complete a letter due to a family emergency and their application was incomplete as a result. So don't be that person. Always ask one more person as a backup. And the second advice is to ask your professors, your class instructors, or your supervisors from your company to write you letters. And don't ask your family, your friends, your significant others to write you a letter because their opinions can be highly biased and won't be valued much. If you're a student, just go to your professor's office hours and get them to know you in person so they can write you a highly personal letter, a specific letter that describes just you as opposed to a very generic letter. Most professors would actually be flattered to write you a letter, so don't be scared to ask for one. Finally, I typically don't recommend actually reading the letter, and I recommend trusting your professor giving you a good recommendation letter and directly submit it to the school. But for international students, I recommend somehow either on your side or the recommender side, make sure that there's no grammar mistake in all of your recommendation letters if your recommender does not speak English as their native language. And this is so important because grammar mistakes, again, reflects lack of attention to detail. So you really want to eliminate that as much as possible.
Now that you have received an invitation to visit the campus, take this as an opportunity to know the people, the culture, and the city. I think what's important is to be able to show your communication skills, and that is to talk about your research in a coherent manner. You also want to demonstrate your passion for their graduate program by giving good energy through conversations. It will be great if you can schedule a time with the professors that you want to work with and get a sense of what it's like to work in their lab. I'm sure you would tour the campus and the city, but to me, the location is less important than how good the school and lab are.
Yeah, one thing I wish I would have done more while I was applying was to contact the professors and see if you know they have available positions or available seats for students. And also get to know more of the research and what to expect when I get there. That's my advice.
GPA is undergrad GPA is like the most important. Not to say other ones are not important.
Oh really?
But GPA is, I would say GPA is
important. I think your research experience is important. Like showing that you have research experience, or that you've thought about it.
Mm-hmm.
I would say personal statement and research experience, because they are kind of
like.
That's why we interview so many people and
optimize every single character.
Oh my god. The first video is gonna be so confusing, but I think in my opinion, let me have another piece of potato.
That's real life.
Yes, it's totally
life is confusing.
Thanks for watching my first vlog video. I hope this has been helpful. And if you have any more questions, please leave at the bottom as a comment and I will address them to the best of my ability. And I will see you next time.